I believe we should start from pleasant things. Our sixth session, Professor McClellan is here. Okay. Since he was absent at the first session, Vernadsky Foundation. Vernadsky Foundation is awarding the Order of Vernadsky. He was the co-chair of our session, Professor McClellan, Great Britain.
Профессор Макленнон, Великобритания, награждается орденом
Вернадского.
Где-то здесь.
Здесь он, да?
Профессор Макленнон.
Профессор Макленнон.
Здесь он или кофе пьет?
He's drinking his coffee. Where is he?
Здесь нет.
Is he here?
Здесь.
Yeah. Okay.
Профессор,
ну, значит, я не знаю,
что делать.
I don't know
what to do. Так, ну что делать? Что делать? Нет. Ну, ладно, тогда мы сделаем другие награды.
So we'll show other awards.
Друзья, я хотел вот пользоваться случаем.
Dear friends, I wanted to use this opportunity.
Ну, давай.
Oh, he's here. Okay, Professor McClellan. This for you. Sure, sure. Yes, it's a nice picture with a nice looking lady. I wanted to use this opportunity.
And on behalf of the Department of Forecasting of Russian Academy of Natural Sciences,
to give a diploma of honorable academician of the Russian Academy of Sciences to Professor Herbert Melch, with whom we are familiar for decades already, and made greatest contribution in the development of Nikolai Kondratyev's theory. And in 1975, in the peak of the crisis, is issued the book entitled Technological Dead End, Technological Stalemate, Innovations Overcoming Depression. And we have agreed that this book will be published in Russia. We agreed with Professor Alin. Therefore, it is my pleasure to bestow this award. Where is the diploma?
Wow. Thank you so much.
I wanted to present an award of corresponding member. Where is the certificate? Okay. It's been accepted a long time ago. Alexei Gromov, representing the new generation. You are a corresponding member. Thank you.
И вы вчера слушали выступление.
And yesterday,
да, минуточку, Алексей Игоревич.
Алексей Игоревич.
Возьмите удостоверение.
Please take your certificate.
Да. Это Герхард Уменьшев.
Герхард, for you.
Так.
We have listened to presentation of great enthusiasts in the field of IP, director of Institute of Standardization and Estimated of Intellectual Property and Business, Boris Leontiev. Is he here?
Спасибо вам большое.
Я поздравляю. И сегодня он тоже будет выступать.
Служу Академии глобалистики.
Науки.
Probably serve to Academy of Globalistics.
Теперь, you serve to the science. Переходим уже к тематике нашей.
Okay, now we move to our session.
Я должен сказать, что
I have to say that it is dedicated to issue of paramount importance for the future. I can speak from here or from there. Okay, I'll start with the introduction.
Я хотел бы сказать, почему вынесена на обсуждение именно эта проблема. Пару недель назад проходили кондратьевские чтения.
A couple of days ago we had Kondratiev readings.
Я там выступил с таким докладом.
Where I have delivered
технологии, циклы Кондратьева.
Kondratiev cycles.
Технологическая слепота.
Technological blindness of elite.
Имея в виду элиту как мировую, так и российскую.
Both world and Russian elite.
Имея в виду элиту.
Meaning.
Государственно-политическую.
State and political elite.
Деловую
and business elite,
и, к сожалению, научную.
And unfortunately, scientific elite as well.
Так остро поставлен вопрос.
Why do I put this
том,
issue of strategic blindness
те,
so
изучал капитал Маркса,
sharply? Those who studied Marx's Capital and his theory of crisis
had
to remember
a
very important discovery. I believe it's very Karl Marx's discovery made with the participation of a practicing capitalist, Friedrich Engels, that the foundation for periodic middle-term crisis is the renewal of the core capital, which is the inside foundation of changes that take place on high levels of development, both in technology and economics. Developing this idea in 1922, Nikolai Kondratiev has published in 1922 and 1926, developing the theory of large cycles, of long cycles of demand. Following Marx, he came to a discovery that the foundation for the long-term cycles is the renewal of capital, creating new industries and requiring large investment. He also demonstrated that Kondratiev waves have three main components. The beginning of demand cycle is a situation that 10, 20 years prior to a large cycle, the wave of scientific discoveries begins. The scientists, that means the scientists are first to react to changes and offer ways out of the crisis situation. Then the wave of innovation comes. Basic innovations, yesterday we discussed it, and innovations for the era when two civilizations, when civilization changes each other. Based on this, the third wave comes, economic wave, the growing wave of large civilization cycle and large Kondratiev cycle. So this thesis, unfortunately, the first two parts are neglected by our political, scientific, business elite. They forgot the first two components, and they concentrate on the third, on the crisis influence, on poverty, on speculation, speculative stock market games, on the changes in virtual economics, World experts estimate that the world that virtual economics is 3 times larger as the GDP, world consolidated GDP. That's a bubble. So the capitalist market has come to in its final stage, that it's doomed to be substituted by a new economic pattern built on real economics. But in the programs of anti-crisis development and the progress and the programs of Austrian school, Keynesian and neo-Keynesian school, modern neoliberal and liberal schools of thought. Unfortunately, this understanding of technological ways out of the crisis is missing. I took part in Rio Plus 10, Rio Plus 20. I've studied all these documents, technological foundation for sustainable development and as a way out of the crisis is not mentioned, is absent. It also is absent from national programs except for the Chinese program probably, because there is the avalanche of both scientific and technological development, which I will mention later. This is the theoretic introduction to the subject of this session. Number two, the crisis we currently live in is not a medium-term crisis. It's not just a change of Kondratiev cycles, the change of civilization cycles. It's what's happening in once in every few centuries. Therefore, majority of analytics practical politicians, when facing this unknown global phenomena, they are unable to understand its essence, nor are they able to determine the strategy to go to get out of this crisis. This is the tragic situation, the growing gap between deep reforms and structural reforms and the understanding of those who make decisions and who prepare the decisions for decision makers. So the main task in the development strategy of overcoming the crisis is to overcome this neoliberal.
It
has been manifested vividly in the policy of International Monetary Foundation towards Southern Europe. They don't understand Marx or Kondratiev. They didn't understand even Keynes. Therefore, this policy is doomed, and millions of people, most of all new generation, suffer from it. You see, half of people who grew up in favorable conditions, in conditions of prosperity, who got education and have no work and no future, it's a precondition for an explosion. New generation can hardly understand what's going on, but they are full of anger, full of indignation. You see what's going on in Ukraine, what's going on in Africa, what's going on in Southern Europe. There's a short, nearsighted policy, blindness of the leaders, leads to tragic results in the future, tragic consequences in the future. So our task is that we have to formulate clearly, which we're doing for a few years, international group of scientists in the Institute of Economic Strategy. We try to provide foundation for the strategy of getting out of the crisis. The key component of it is the scientific revolution of the 21st century and mastering the sixth technological mode as material embodiment of the changes that will take place in manufacturing and will, on the wave of innovation, will lead to economic growth and social development. Therefore, I believe that the task we have ahead of us is first to understand the essence and to help others see, help other scientists, politicians and businessmen to understand that the key out of the crisis, the key to transition of sustainable development is the science and technology. I have to say that this revolution is not something that's going to happen. Many people just don't see it, but the revolution is taking place now. It takes place in the area of science, first of all, in social sciences, where Russia is the center, the group of scientists working on this concept. The academia we started yesterday, so I have to stress, knowing the state of world science, that we are leaders here. But looking realistically in the field of innovation, the field of transition to practical, definitely China is the leader. When I looked at the statistics, I was amazed to see the changes taking place in the last 12 years. The number of applications for patents in China has grown 16 times, 16.4 to be exact.
The share of inventions
implemented in high-tech products indicates China to be the leader in high-tech, 25 to 26% of world export, leaving the United States far behind. China is the leader in chemical production, with the most impressive figures. Definitely a huge number of people that are involved in this process. Unfortunately, we do not see it, neither in Russia nor in other countries. The innovation activity is growing very slow, and also very slow growth in India. India is lagging behind. So our task is to see these processes and to understand their future, and to do it in such a way as to instill in our programs, in our perspective, in the brains of new generation, to instill the understanding of this factor that should be a lead to the rise of the new wave of science, scientific revolution, which is taking place now, and to become, it will become the foundation of the technological revolution of the 21st century.
To beat the previous record of the third quarter of the 20th century is impossible because the demographic factor and the technological factor will not allow us, but to reach the high tempo, high speed of development of this is a technological basis. Feasible to achieve, and we have to concentrate on this objective. I took a little bit more time. The tough time limit, too many people to want to say a word from this chair, so we want to them to reduce their presentations to 5 to 7 minutes. But the floor, I want to give the floor to my friend and the classic of the neo-economic sort of the previous decade, Professor Gerbert Menchen.
Юрий, I thank you so much for your
Юрий, большое тебе спасибо за то введение, то представление, как ты меня прекрасно представил. Я вообще, ты за это все твоих рук дело, что меня пригласили, наградили в Российскую академию наук. Просто у меня тут все внутри просто дрожит, и моя дружа, мое тело это нравится, моему душе это нравится, и особенно мне нравится.
Natural science.
А что я стал членом секции естественных наук России.
To take natural science
новые возможности. Я теперь могу
out of where physics
науками.
And chemistry is strong in the geosphere and take it where natural science in biology is strong in the biosphere. And take it a step further, Вернадский, Тайлар Дешаден, who's Elsa Тайлар, my friend, satellite and take it into the noosphere, where there are processes of thinking and processes of feeling. And I'm very happy about, because natural science is the scientific basis for feeling, not only thinking, for feeling. And therefore, if this venture here, which is an epochal innovation, that there are people like you and you, there is Askar and Askar, there's Yuri and Yuri, and there is this young man whose wife just left, who the other day over dinner, she knew the new basis for this is bio, this is plasma physics. This is plasma physics as it goes into zero, as our friend Matthew shows it, where the singularities are, and the thinking and feeling about singularities, that needs a scientific basis which is consistent with natural science. Okay. Thank you. Translator, am I too fast?
Perfect. You are perfect.
Too fast?
No, you are not. You are perfect.
Then I slow down.
You shouldn't. Why? You are not fast. You shouldn't slow down at all.
Maybe 10 minutes.
I will take maybe 10 more, minutes of know. Your...
I go by the rule, I have 10 minutes. And since I want you to come have the opportunity at least for two questions, I will cut my presentation to 8 minutes.
Я сокращу свою презентацию до 8 минут, а 2 минуты.
So the 9th minute and the 10th minute is for questions.
То есть 8 минут, а 9 и 10 минуты для вопросов, которые вы мне зададите. Первое. Дорогие дамы и господа,
I shall say what I'm going to say.
Вот я хочу сказать то, что хочу сказать.
Secondly,
второе.
From minute 3 to 8,
с третьей по четвертую минуту я это буду говорить.
In minute 8,
I'll say what I said. Скажу, что я сказал, подведу итоги.
Oh, I liked your comments on Marxism yesterday.
Мне понравился ваш комментарий по марксизму вчера.
By the way, since you just distracted me, I think one of the greatest Russian heritage is Markov, natural science, process science in Markovian properties, and my friends here and the pioneer in new cyclical Russian cyclicism cannot be understood fully without here being the Russian heritage of Markov. Processes with linear thinking and all the depth applied to something which is non-linear, so it's not just standing still like that, but it is non-linear in the past, coming back to us, and it's non-linear in the future, and combining that and finding patterns where you are a pioneer in cyclicism, and the Askars are pioneers in structuralism, in Russian structuralism. And by the way, since Alex Akhenev is here, he's the editor-in-chief of this economic strategy, you see in the end this article 5 pages about the plasma physical basis of the kind of thinking when we go from material into immaterial, into intangible. And to pay you back, Yuri, because you had the foresight to call the Kondratyev Society the Sorokin Kondratyev Society and Institute. Sorokin is back because in 1927, at the same time when Heisenberg did the thing, At the same time, when C.D. Young said the thing about synchronicity, Sorokin wrote the book on social mobility, in which he defined social mobility as a special case of social circulation.
Социальный,
and if we have to understand anything about civilizational development, it will be circulation of human talents and skill and knowledge and all that. You, ladies and gentlemen, find that out there. Russian heritage and the development of the last 10 years.
И в развитии, которое оно получило в последние 10 лет.
I'm going to say that.
Что я хочу вот сказать?
Coming to two pictures.
Хочу вот остановиться на двух картиночках.
Which allow me to phrase an hypothesis. A hypothesis.
Сформулировать гипотезу.
This is picture one, and it is French structuralism.
Это идея французского структурализма.
Because you see, the French, they divided the economy into four sectors. First is agriculture and mining, and then came the industrial revolution in sector two, and then services in sector three, and then four, the fourth sector. And now comes the fifth sector. Would you turn the picture one up?
Переверните страничку-то вот, пожалуйста.
There it is, the fifth sector. And it is a bunch of innovations that come from the first sector and from the second sector, innovations from the third sector, and innovations from the third sector and the fourth sector, forming a new fifth sector. And we cannot understand the innovation processes, the reform processes that are driven by the fifth sector without recognizing that these innovations originate with people that come from agriculture and mining and from industry and from science, and they are doing something that is demand side, that is pulled by needs. And that is what you Chinese fellows brought to the table here as this innovative part of it. It is need pulled. It is not supply pushed, technology pushed. It is need pulled. And who are the needy people? Our friend from Kenya. If you go a bit further to a Central African Republic, there are 22% of the population younger than 18 years old. Half of the children are children of children. I have three grandchildren. They are children of my daughter. She was 35 when the first one came. But children of children in that Central African region, they are children of 13-year-olds. If there is no need out there, you're blind. There is a terrific need out there. And therefore, these innovations driven by structural shift processes. Structural shift is the landmark word, ASCAR. Not ASCAR, IEF. The other ASCAR used in his book last year on structural dynamics. That is Russian structural change, and the hypothesis is... I have to look this up, I forgot. Because I'm so passionate, so excited. It is the hypothesis of hope.
Это гипотеза надежды.
And I use three H's because it is the hypothesis of higher hope.
И это еще более, это гипотеза высочайшей надежды.
We come from the Midwest, and there we have higher hopes, not just average hope.
Нет, это не надежда такая средненькая надежда, это высокие, высокого пошиба надежды.
Which leads me, your word expectation, into the second. Here comes the conjecture, the second hypothesis, the conjecture that
что
in this time and age, in this hiatus, in this period, again, like in history, we have a turbulence, and in this turbulence, there are smaller turbulences and bigger turbulences. But in this turbulence, the breakthrough of the new will come faster than it did in previous periods in history. So what you see there,
то есть то, что вы видите
здесь, you see there in the middle, there are these curves,
в середине вы видите вот эти кривые, да?
There are these speed curves.
Это кривые скорости.
And the older ones, I have superimposed them here, and the older ones from earlier periods in history, there the speed up is more gradual, and the more we come into modern times, the more radical is the speed up, the more swiftly, the more quickly it happens. Now we go quickly through a number of these pictures.
И сейчас мы быстро пролистнем несколько таких картин.
Curves of change, they are based on data about 400 or so processes in history, and they are dated in time and in amplitude.
И вот амплитуда.
And you see these dots, they are clustering about power curves.
Вы видите, они все приближаются к кривым.
That show memory.
This
picture here is about the cluster of 17 processes of innovation, which I have studied in my book on the Industrial Revolution. And if one takes the timing and allocates the time at the proper breakthrough time, then the speed curve, then the temporal relaxation curve in time converts into a simple speed curve. That's what this is.
Next page.
So the first curve of that is that on the left-hand side, and then there are the numbers and the curves that sort of non-linearly fit these bunches, which show there is evidence that the bases of these change processes, they are strongly patterned. We know since 30 years there's a quadrative cycle in there, and there are other forces.
Есть другие силы, которые движут этими процессами.
That's how it looks like in chemistry.
Вот так это выглядит.
That is in the chemical and electrical industries in the 19th century.
Could you go back, please? И другие отрасли выглядели в 90-х годах. Назад верните, пожалуйста. Спасибо.
And they are different.
Нет, верните.
The point is, if you are disaggregating them, if you go from macro to meso and micro, the fit becomes better. So the more we go away from macro cycle and look into the micro data, that's what Asar did masterfully, as soon as we do that, the fit gets much better.
То мы видим, что они больше соответствуют тому,
if we go down to the micro, where individual processes of innovation take place, our knowledge gets better and better.
Наше знание становится больше, мы все лучше и лучше понимаем, что происходит.
As a professional, what I do to make a living and to have fun is, I'm managing a research group, an innovation research group, that looks into these innovations that are now driving the fifth sector. That is micro foundation to the macro science. That's what we do in innovation financing. And the challenge is that most of the pension funds, the public pension funds and the private pension funds, They don't understand the innovation processes, therefore they think the risk is too high, therefore they do not finance innovation, and therefore your salary and your retirement income and your retirement income is only this, because you did not get the return on investment in innovation. If you would have return on investment in innovation factors, your retirement income may be this high, or it may be this high. So on the financial side, we use this knowledge to be more productive with money, with our money, and the sum total of this is that it is expected that with the change in behavior of the pension funds,
Japan,
in China, in
London,
in Washington, this will be not only a dream, that this reform movement will be something we scientists think about. No.
Это не останется
the
просто чистой наукой. За этим всем будут деньги, реальные деньги. Может принести реальный доход.
We skip through these pictures.
Давайте
here.
Пропустим.
There are two more pictures that show the derivative. This is the investment. We are in no-o science. We are in how investors think and how investors feel about risk and opportunity. And that is highly non-linear mathematics. So this is a depiction of the feelings and the confidence and the sentiments that are no scientifically based processes.
There they are.
That's how they look like.
Процессов. Вот как они выглядят.
Next picture.
Еще следующая картинка.
And they can be quantified.
They
can be depicted as being smaller and slower and weaker versus bigger, stronger, and something so they are more sustainable over time, and how many years is the sentiment standing there, and how productive will a strong sentiment be if a collective like us get together and say, let's do something about it. Next picture. So behind it is a multi-valued, ambivalent path modeling that differentiates the timing, the seed phase, the start phase. In German, we have good expression, we call it Anlaufphase, Vorlaufphase, Zulaufphase, Nachlaufphase. So the words that differentiate the timing is something which is modern physics, isn't it? And there are multiple paths, and no science is to find paths, to find those paths that are feasible, and that is something Sorokin told us already in 1927. In social mobility.
So,
as Vladimir Vernadsky said, the future is in our hands. In the biosphere, they call the new branch of science life science. And in the noosphere, we call the anticipatory processes that have memory, we call them hope science.
And it is hope
for our grandchildren, for the next generation.
для следующих поколений.
Герхард, о времени не забывайте.
Third, to wrap it up. The summary and conclusion.
Итак,
I can formulate my hypothesis, the higher hope hypothesis, and the conclusion that the ethical, moral, and other sentiments can be wrapped up, for example, as Christian hope,
могут быть представлены как христианская надежда.
Since I'm a Christian, I might as well call it Christian.
Я называю это.
So for the glory of God, it will come faster, it will be more effective. So going from 7 billion people to 10 billion people need not be catastrophical. It could be that God has something in mind, something critical, that 10 million is a threshold or something.
You we haven't even thought about. А что-то такое, о чем мы не думали. Я предлагаю вам теорему.
And no scientific theorem that wraps up that hypothesis and that wraps up that conjecture.
Тенденцию,
and if you are interested, I'll show you the math that proves
суммирует, эту гипотезу. И если вы хотите, там ее доказательство.
We have a minute and a half for two questions.
Полторы минуты на два вопроса.
Есть вопросы?
Any questions?
Thank you.
Хорошо, thank you.
Спасибо.
The one that walks 7 feet above the ground. Yeah. Yeah, that's the question.
Please use the microphone.
Спасибо. Ну, классику мы дали побольше времени.
Thank you. Well, we gave a little more time to the classic. Others will have 5 to 6 minutes.
Андрей Владимирович здесь? Здесь, да?
The floor goes to Andrei Ostrovsky, Deputy Director of the Russian Academy of Sciences Institute for Far Eastern Studies. He is specialist in Chinese studies. And next speaker is Mr. Gromov. I thank the organizer of the conference for giving the opportunity to speak at this conference. Yuri Vladimirovich has already touched partially the issue of technological revolution in China and development of science. In these 5 to 6 minutes that I have allocated to me, I can't say much, but I will just present a brief summary. Within the last few years, the development of science and technology become the more pronounced factor of success of economic reform and building the prosperity, which in Chinese is called Xiaokan. China 2 years ago has encountered a very serious problem of decrease of economically active population. Therefore, China may not look at recruiting low-qualified workforce from the village, from the rural areas, so they have to look for more qualified labor, including labor in agriculture. That means that within the next 5 years, China will have to move from extensive forms of development of production to intensive to development of innovative economics. That means that more and more attention will be paid to development of science and technology. Successes are quite tangible. China has just launched spaceship, which will reach the moon surface, and China will thus become the third world power that has sent its spaceship to the moon. They have launched a man to the sky. They have used the Batiska, one of the most, one of the fastest computers in the world, Tianhe. The network of speed railroads. Currently, I'd like to mention that there are two main indicators in China which they pay special attention. The first is share of expenses on education in GDP and the share of research allocations prior development stages. The indicative plans are now including the plans for development of science and research. Allocations for R&D should be more than 2.2%, and the number of patents 3.3 per 10,000 population. Speaking about the prehistory of science development within the period of reform in China, four large programs of development has been set: 1986, program 863, which set the goals for formation of innovative potential China in high-tech. The next program called for creation of new innovation technologies. Currently in China there are 56 zones, high-tech zones, and 54 centers of innovation services. And in Russia we have only Skolkovo and Rosnano, as far as I know. Well, that's what we have.
В 1986,
the SPARK program has been adopted to introduce innovations of science and technology into agriculture, and in 1996, the State Committee on Development of China and Techniques had adopted program 1973, specifying areas of agriculture, information scientists, health care, production, manufacture of new materials, something that is widely discussed on this conference on globalization. Therefore, China is going with the times, and Chinese science and education and technology are looking ahead forward. Prior, the policy has provided tax benefits and financial benefits to the structures from different fiscal sources. The companies who were involved in innovation, they got fiscal benefits and finance for import of new technologies from abroad. As for motherboards and software, there was a benefit period when no taxes have been charged and been collected at all. There are three main areas of development of science and technology in China: energy, water resources, and environmental protection. I'd like to mention the following, that within the 20 years, since 1991 to 2011, there was a growth of those employed in R&D, 3.5, including engineers and scientists, 3.9, and the share of allocated to R&D are 3.83%, but the growth, but the China has not reached 2% of GDP threshold that has been set. Last period, the innovative economy has been rapidly developing in China, and one has to mention such areas as biotechnology, information technology, nanomaterials, atomic energetics, aviation technology, space technology, missile technique, and renewable sources of energy. These are the main areas where we can expect breakthrough in the nearest future on the part of Chinese science and technology. I'd like to mention the following: zones for high-tech development have been created, which are not only generating high-tech innovations, but implementing them in practice and creating high-tech products, which most bulk of it is exported. Since 2001, China has had the first place in such indicator as share of high-tech export. Three most developed cities: Beijing, Shanghai, and three most developed provinces mentioned by the speaker. Recently, the China comes to a new level of technology due to their rapid development of zones of high-tech. Now, please pay attention to the slides. These are China achievements in research and science. This Xiaolong, the Sea Dragon. Speed railway track Harbin-Dalian. In the near future, all provincial centers will be linked, connected by high-speed railroads from Beijing to Shanghai, 4.5 hours. These are moon photographs, high resolution by satellite Chang'e 2 and Wuchang 3. This is a supercomputer in Jinan, high capacity. Vaccine to prevent hepatitis E, new generation of engine, foray in quantum information, Nanotechnological University of China, which for the first time in the world was able to link 8 photons. Atomic power, Yalan, near Shenzhen in the south of China, new neutrino oscillation, and the last 65 meters radio telescope completed in China's laboratory. These are concrete results. And the last point, nanotechnology is rapidly developing in China, five areas: information transfer, biopharmaceuticals, energy resources, environment protection, and functional companies. The analysis show that China, United States, Japan, and Republic of Korea have highest indicators. Russian Academy of Sciences, we are the leaders in the number of publications. We are on the first three, but the main challenge is that patents are not generated from these publications, and no innovations are not resulting in innovation. The main thing in China's experience of innovative development is that for 30 years China has implemented the scientific policy, developing long-term and medium-term program of development of science and technology, training of staff, and increase of state allocations to R&D up to 2.5% GDP. Thank you. There was a period when China has actually learned from the Soviet Union. Now it's our turn to learn from the Chinese, not only Russia, how to master technological revolution. The floor goes to Alexei Gromov, who has just received a diploma of corresponding member of Academy of Sciences. Mr. Leontiev, please get ready. Good afternoon, dear colleagues. It's a great honor for me to speak in the hall of the Russian Academy of Sciences, and I would like to present our joint presentation of Institute of Energetic Strategy, which we prepared jointly with Vitaly Bushuyev.
Наш институт достаточно давно занимается энергетическим стратегированием и долгосрочным прогнозированием.
И сегодня мы бы хотели поделиться теми наработками, которые рождаются в нашем институте, касающимися структурного прогнозирования и будущего цивилизационного развития. В этой связи я полностью согласен с той концепцией, которую сегодня Владимир Владимирович в рамках нашего конгресса, что мир сегодня переживает болезненный, сложный переход transition to a new civilization development stage. Next slide, please. I'd like to say that 21st century is beginning. The 21st century is the time of formation of new civilization within the framework of global system, nature, society, and the man. The core of this system is energetics because it provides economics, environmental harmonization of relationship in social, natural media with all they do prerequisite for the resistance, the unity of is based on environment, allow us to avoid the opposing humanitarian and man-made factors and natural factors. And environment and unity create base for placing the industry. Close cooperation of experts from both fields allows to define the borders of reasonable pressure on energetics on the part of the environment, and the huge potential of energetics is getting energy from natural sources. Nature is the source of renewable energy. Renewable energetics is just the first step towards access to really renewable source of energy from new media. It's also important to say that in the future, energetics will produce no waste.
The
crossing of economics and energetics lies an opportunity to level discrepancies in energy between different regions of the world, which is increased energetic security. Also, there are alternative models for sustainable economic development.
Its
environment, social science on other parts, creates definite, its own perspective for economic development, sets a fashion for the development of renewable sources of energy, which in turn gives impetus to a different sector of energetics and economy. Due to environment, the attention to environmental components affect the development of agriculture and construction industry. The idea of harmony of man and global economic system calls not for the protection of nature from anthropogenic influence, it's the concept of the past, but a new development meaning efficient use of previously created energetic potential, its renewal and harmonious core development of economics and society. Energetic interaction in the framework of system, man, nature, society passes through set series of crisis periods. This is the focus for the next 100 years. Dynamics of world energy consumption. What are the curves of development, which points we have passed, and which curves we have come to. We are now in the point of 2010 crisis, when the further exponential development of the majority of energy potential is no longer possible. So we transfer to a new stage of development of civilization. And here I'd like to share with you
structural perceptions of the future global system of the humankind for the few 100 years to come, which we have developed based on the
author's
methods for the analysis of cyclic, which was developed in the Institute of Energetic Strategy. It is shown on this slide, where we use the approach, by using the approach of the principle of magnetism, which is based on the transfer of energy from different status to another, which ensures the development in economics and materialism and fractal and and the principles of golden section and cycles of global development from political dawn, from the from stagnation and decline. And in this logic, we formulated the civilizational portal of the development of the society of civilization, if you wish, for the whole 21st century, as it's seen from today, based on the mythology which is developed in our institute. The distinctive feature of the new civilization, the global approach, is transfer from consumerism to social, natural humanism, when a human being is not acts as a consumer, but organizer of the Hamole Sustainable Development. Of what is done. What you see in the slide is a general attempt to represent the features of the future energetic system, but it is clear now that the world is changing rapidly, and the crisis resonance of the 2010s, it is not the end or crisis which is destructing, but it is the beginning of a new fractal of the development of the world ecosystem. This slide shows that the first structure of structural wave of development is in progress now. It is an industrial renaissance on a new technological base, which is called neo-industrial development. The good example of this is the United States, which are actively using new technologies and new alternative energy carriers in order to overcome the crisis about society, world communities has found itself recently. Neo-industrial development is pushing the driver of the material production, but it doesn't liberate us from the solution to very topical energy problems. The effect it has on the nature of person and the factors which really cause the climate change, which are typical for structure for cycles, which bring to scale economic crisis, which will eventually turn economy to the declining the carbohydrate economy. And in the future, we can expect, at the base of the technological development, the inclination to individualization of the economy, meeting individual needs. But it is not the final point of the civilization development, because maximum of meeting the human needs will bring to the consumer crisis, because it's impossible all the time to striving for material consumerism. And in the second part of the 21st century, the world will be moving in this direction. The future is in favor of this noospheric civilization, the methodology which we are studying today, even today at this Congress. Thank you very much. Who is interested in more detail of this concept? It is published in the magazine Partnership of Civilizations. Please address us. We will be happy to answer the questions. This is your medal. Thank you very much. Our young generation of our scientists, you know, has this optimistic note, you know, you see this example of, they accept the approach by academician Akaev. The floor goes to the director of Institute of Stratification, Boris Leontiev. And the second will be the Jen next in
line.
Once again, good afternoon. I will start from terms. When our thought is, you know, driven by the word social, I want to draw your attention to the fact that biological world is built on the basis of social organization. There is no nothing specifically humane. If you are talking about information society, you are talking about the subjects which reproduce information. More information is produced by
об интеллектуальной природе, вы говорите об ученых и творцах.
Поэтому
давайте, вот я просто предлагаю перевести акценты на интеллектуальную природу. Тем более, что интеллектуальная природа еще интересна тем, что она естественная. И если до сих пор было в Академии естественных наук отделение экономики и социологии, как системы социальных знаний, гуманитарных знаний, то с введением понятия
интеллектуальной природы, вот эти все интеллектуальные процессы, они становятся естественно научными. В общем, так сказать, важность перехода.
Но это, так сказать, для начала. Значит,
моя задача сегодня очень коротко сказать о новой интеллектуальной экономике. Дело в том, что Юрий Владимирович совершенно правильно сказал, что сегодня вот эта виртуальная спекулятивная экономика работает. Но в чем ее виртуальность и спекулятивность? Дело в том, что традиционная экономика, которая сейчас транслируется из западных стран, США и так далее, она двухфазна. Там рассматривается финансовый и материальный капитал.
А
мы говорим про трехфазную экономику, где вот этот интеллектуальный капитал начинает работать. И функции в экономике материального финансового капитала и интеллектуального, они разные. Значит, интеллектуальный капитал является системообразующим. Интеллектуальный капитал является системообразующим. Финансовый капитал является стимулирующим,
то есть обслуживающим,
а материальный – овеществляющим результатом. Вот если вы оставляете, так сказать, два капитала, стимулирующий и овеществляющий, у вас мешанина получается. Вот то, что мы видим в экономических учебниках. Там нет начала, нет конца. Возьмите любых авторов, 10 авторов, экономистов, увидите, что у них содержание совершенно разное. Они не стараются не повторять друг друга, не гордятся этим. Хотя наука, как наука, это должно быть выстраиваться совершенно четко. Есть экономика, будем говорить, личности, есть экономика семьи, есть экономика предприятия, есть экономика отрасли, есть экономика региона, есть экономика государства, есть международная, глобальная экономика. Это отдельная песня. Значит, но тогда дело в том, что когда мы вот с такой иерархической позиции подходим к экономике, то это все моделируется очень, я бы сказал, легко. Почему? Потому что в интеллектуальной
system, there are so-called equivalent logic.
В теории,
in the theory of ideas, there are three fundamental features of ideas.
Formalization,
what is printed, something which is in your consciousness, something which is printed,
and
thirdly, materialization, how well it can be implementation, degree of implementation. When we use all three features and see, examine all three, then we see that, in fact, it's a language of nature, of the intellectual nature.
Материя, пространство, время,
matter of the space and time is about this.
Это материализуемость, время формализуемость, потому что время в природе
time is formalizing because time doesn't exist in
нature.
Nature only knows cycles.
Которые мы наблюдаем. Кстати,
annual cycles
and
day-night cycles. I had a publication in
Nauka
и Жизнь magazine. I said that the wise people, sages, they looked for third cycles. They built these cyclopic buildings to see how the sun works according to the third cycle, has become more and more increasingly popular. This equivalent logic, according to it, there are intelligent intellectual capital, financial capital, and material capital, which are the foundation of the economy. What shapes, what forms can it take? The special ideas in our modern theory, there are special theories that are called idiosphere, systems of knowledge, formalized, materialized, or whatever you wish.
Формализуемость дает нам циклические идеи,
cyclic ideas, we are called them cycloids.
как сказать, математическая кривая.
There are mathematical curves, cycloid, and there are cycloids.
То, что является циклом, как сказать, циклически воспроизводится. В экономике вся строится.
Duplicating in cycle. Economy is all built on cycles. And material ideas, materialize effectors. In biology, they are used for at least 70 years, but unfortunately, it is not, doesn't go further from biology. In economy, there is efficiency, but there is no source of the effect. Efficiency effect, but no effectors. The main effect in our life is the sun, but in the society the effectors are clever, smart, intelligent people which reproduce the discoveries, patents, in the patents, innovation, they are social effectors. The whole microeconomics and management is built on
с одной стороны, менеджер управляет эффекторами, это
is adopted to the, for 6 years it has been adopted in the scientific term, inventorization of scientific property, intellectual property, to measure and assess intellectual property.
Вытащить конкретный
because
актив
you
и точно
this,
сказать, какой эффект он дает. Если ты инвентаризацию не провел, вот этого системного понимания этих эффекторов не произвел, то ты никогда не вытащишь конкретный актив и не скажешь, что он будет функционально, с одной стороны, значением и, с другой стороны, что он дает. Поэтому оценку ты не произведешь.
Fraction of effect which it can produce with evaluators of the intellectual property are assessing the evaluating this mechanism of inventory of the intellectual property. So two-phase economy which exists today, the crisis economy,
because under pseudo-effectors
are used, derivatives of effectors, for which American specialists are granted Nobel Prize. The secondary and tertiary
передают друг другу бумаги через
третий, четвертый, пятый, а там нет никакой интеллектуальной собственности,
эти бумаги ничего не стоят, эти бумаги
наводняют рынок, цены бумаг. And which decided to determine this crisis, the time limit is over. In conclusion, I want to say that the modeling through equivalent logic of functions of the intellectual property in business, in the industry,
на уровне государства и на межгосударственном
уровне,
оно нами произведено, это все опубликовано, специалисты совсем познакомились, мировая общественность с этим ознакомилась, значит, институт интеллектуальной собственности, который действует уже 500 лет во всем мире, он гораздо шире на самом деле, чем вся мировая экономика, этот институт является основой понимания перераспределения всех благ на земном шаре. Он перераспределяет это. Не понимать этого значит не понимать ничего.
On the planet Earth. If we don't understand this, we don't understand anything.
Это уже тет-а-тет.
Jean Zhen Lian is the next presenter.
It's
modern energy of superconducting mobile reserve. Is he with us?
Yes, yes.
Is he here? No, he's not. Let's present Samar Aliyev, deputy director.
Now
he's in Armenia, getting Armenia prepared for the Customs Union. Then let's present one tier, chairman of the board of directors, Patashin Violet Raisin, Shaanxi province. No, he's not. Oh, is he here? No. He's not here with us. Then Professor Lazareva of the Southern Federal University. We're talking about modern specifics of trajectories. Now all the presenters are dissolving from here. Then Professor Kochetov of the Bauman University. Yes, he's here with us. So make your way to the floor. So you can have additional minute for all those who are absent. And after him will be Валерий Абрамов.
Уважаемые коллеги, более точное название этого доклада – социальная цель и технологический способ бескризисного ноосферного развития
наций. Do you like the sound of it? I do.
Происходит саморегуляция.
The world is in the world, that it was the summer self-regulation of the animal and plant world. It is the predator's effect on the population of the world is done by the American economic tycoon. Social contradictions.
It's something based
on the discrepancy between the income between the most wealthy and most poor, and the wealth of the country and wealth of the nation.
Another
contradiction is between the power and subjectives and methods of achieving. The objective may be social, but the methods may be really so different. Real economy, real economics, and doesn't exist in the world. Whatever you watch it on TV or in mass media, on the internet, elsewhere, everybody is talking about money, as if all the economists from the whole world try to manage money. Something similar was said by Дмитрий Менделеев.
If
precious oil is used as fuel, it is the same. It is the same as to feed your stove by, you know, banknotes. American apologetic to the economic growth. They don't reflect the production. Only money. So the issue of the product depends on the investment of the labor and on capital. We look at the completely different economy. This the production process is the transfer of resources with the help of labor into production.
This is a process that the economy of the world lacks. Yuri Yakovets has justly mentioned that Europeans have forgotten its case and Karl Marx, fully ignoring this outstanding scientist. Next poster. No, the previous one.
Межнациональные идеи и путь мирного развития. Нам пришлось проанализировать более 50 национальных идей разных стран мира. Все там являются эти национальные идеи в виде экологических таких лозунгов, которые не формализуются алгебраически, то есть не формализуются, которые можно реализовать практически.
And thus are not possible to implement them in practice. Same is true for Russia.
Авиационный инженер Гарифуллин.
Aviation engineer Гарифуллин in 2004 has published a brochure.
Благополучие каждой семьи и самореализация каждого человека, национальные идеи сильного государства, богатой страны.
self-realization of each person in which country.
10,000
copies have been published, and in the end he writes, concrete fact that the international idea is the individual happiness based on the family prosperity. The transition to the sixth technological mode,
he writes
that compulsory general higher education is requested in all countries of the world as a result of intellectual growth. Women in countries of Asia and Africa will plan the number of kids, and there will be an equilibrium between decreasing number of people on the world and the irrenewable resources. So there will not be 12 trillion population in some time, maybe in half a century, the population growth will reverse. The opposite way to the current situation, which is now led by American magnates. Next poster, please. Just a minute. Next.
Noosphere
of social development. Noosphere, according to Vernadsky, is the sphere of intellect, interactional between society and nature, the borders of which are the area for man's activity. Technosphere is the sphere created by man as a agglomeration of ways to provide activity of mankind. Also, the activity of companies, scientific progress is the foundation for technological progress, economic development, and social development. Through transition of one technological mode to the next, for example, the sixth technological mode. Therefore, productivity with the growth of individual labor liberates time for intellectual development of the society. Next poster, please. Next. I have named the idea, national idea, which suits each country of the world, any country of the world. Technological function is an instrument for its implementation. Therefore, technological function here is presented here as the level of growth of efficiency of new production compared to the previous one. And this growth we can forecast as a normative level, as a number, which shows how agglomerated technical, monetary, natural indicators, ergonomic indicators, economic indicators. How can you, with this single formula, determine how the efficiency, of domestic or foreign manufacturing will be compared to its competitors? Therefore, we set the norm for development of a country, of an industry, of a company, of a and thus we can select new technologies, new products, and new manufacturing sites. Go back. Below is a general poker function. General management function. The sequence of production, planning, organization, control, and regulation. The estimate here is E, estimation, R, regulation.
Давайте вернемся к универсальной идентичной классификации УДК, которая поддерживается всеми странами мира. Там указано, что блок организации относится к научно-исследовательской инфраструктуре, технологической подготовке производства. Поэтому блок регулирования идет блок организации.
Is part goes to organization, thus providing feedback, avoiding crisis development. What is sustainability principle? Next poster, yeah, the main.
Ну, цикличность развития, я об этом говорил. Давайте дальше.
Cyclic development.
А нет,
no.
Цикличность развития еще покажите.
Cyclic development.
Дело в том, что цикличность развития для обеспечения управляемости и устойчивости вынуждает создать отраслевые министерства, именно отраслевые институты, и поддерживать научно-исследовательские работы, которые у нас уничтожены почти полностью во всей стране. Как мы нашу фундаментальную науку можем реализовывать, когда на английском языке публикуют других стран с развитием технологий, а у нас технологии погублены, нет отраслевых министерств.
Technology is killed here. So the leaders of industry are forced to constantly get involved into research and development, thus avoiding technological breaks. Next poster, please.
Normative technological function. В технологической функции у нас открытие закономерной взаимосвязи социально-экономических показателей технических параметров
производства, названное
не по моему желанию,
Сухочетова, the technological function which allows to resolve more than 30 different tasks, starting from the individual production section in any country for any type of product, regardless of time of implementation. Here we introduce the index of human potential, which is changed compared to the one suggested by the UN, changed including the factor of size. Education level and longevity. There is an index on intellectual development we can borrow from the internet. Therefore, we understand that the intellectual development is the consequence of economic and social development. But we have to make consequences, which have to turn into a cause. Therefore, we take this cause for the last 5 years, which are causes for the next period of forecast.
И еще последний пакет. Еще покажите.
Show one more.
Ну, панацея.ру, вы можете в интернете посмотреть, система поиска медицин, по диагнозам, по болезням для каждого человека и так далее, реализуется с помощью этого подхода.
Mental diagnosis for every person.
Автотрофное питание. Вот Вернадский говорил о том, что для решения
социального вопроса необходимо подойти social issues. We have to approach, what do you call it? We have to change nutrition, sources of energy. With the discovery of autotrophic bread, challenges of hunger and poverty will be resolved, including challenges of violence. They will be eradicated. In the section of atmospheric technologies of Russian Academy of Sciences, where I am head of, project has been developed for research of autotrophic nutrition, nature, structure. This is the scientific project number one. It's called Ambrosia. For the first time in the world, a new science is introduced, a new theory of development of all the countries based on social ideas implemented with the technological functions, the recommendations are developed for improvement of state management of any nation, any country. And to secure management, any government has to have a special agency, state committee on technology and science, branch ministries, Academy of Science, independent of bureaucrats and ministries. Thank you for your attention. The floor goes to Валерий Абрамов.
Значит, мы сейчас будем Я почему награждаю этих, презентация предусмотрена.
Well, its presentation we have jointly prepared, the forecast, dynamics of science and technological development, the period of change of technological information cycles.
Спасибо огромное. Уважаемые коллеги,
dear colleagues, thank you very much. I wanted to thank you for an opportunity to present, to make a presentation here. And I would like to continue the discussion which Professor Gerhard Mensch and Boris Leontiev have started when they spoke about the moving forces for the development of the fifth and sixth technological modes of noospheric civilization. As it is well known that national treasures of the leading countries of the world are only 5% of them are natural resources, 80% productive capital, while 3/4 are knowledge, skills, intellectual property, intellectual capital. Therefore, intellectual capital becomes the leading factor of competitive ability. Very briefly, I'd like to show you the results of studies which we have used when preparing
научно-исследовательской работы по заказу Евразийской экономической комиссии по разработке целостной концепции охраны и защиты интеллектуальной собственности в странах Таможенного союза и Евразийского экономического союза.
Значит, в основу были
результаты исследования, которая четко определила возможности
clearly defined, clearly defined the ability of contribution to economic indicators in EU, in the Eurasian Union, the companies which are intensively using the IP rights. For those who are interested, it shows that the sources are
easy
the source for the report which we use as methodology. I'd like to say very briefly that this study is in part unique
достаточно большое количество заявлений о вкладе интеллектуальной собственности
contributions of intellectual property to economic growth, there were no concrete studies of this phenomenon, and this is one of the first in kind. Next slide. These studies clearly show that companies which
результаты интеллектуальной деятельности инновации
the results of innovations provide 26% of employment in EU, European Union. And here the contribution of each object of intellectual property, trademarks, industrial design, patents, copyright. These companies who are extensively using the results of intellectual activity in the European Union, they provide 38, almost 39% of contribution to GDP. Another important point here is revealed by the study that the companies who actively use IP and innovations pay their employees 41% higher salary than other companies in respective industries. Traditional way of estimate of compatibility, competitive ability of economics is their contribution towards international trade. The study has shown that in the structure of products imported by EU countries, 98 percent is a product based on innovation and intellectual property. And the the above was about export. The products which are imported also contain high share of IP. This is one of the ways of estimating the competitive ability of national economy,
economies
used by the World Economic Forum. Next slide, please. As you all know, dear colleagues, please, next slide. Next one. Next one, please. As you all know it, I will not read it. Just next slide, I want to draw your attention to the fact that only two of them business maturity level and its ability to work according to international standards and innovative potential is to define competitive ability of economics based on knowledge and use of intellectual capital.
Интеллектуального капитала и результатов интеллектуальной собственности.
Нам
представляется, что с точки зрения методологии,
в настоящее время
два вышеназванных подхода
являются
сильным аналитическим и политическим инструментом для достижения высокой конкурентоспособности, который является основой устойчивого экономического развития и создания устойчивых конкурентных преимуществ
competitive advantages in the global civilization. Dear colleagues, thank you for your attention and for the opportunity to speak before outstanding scientists, world-renowned scientists who define sustainable development of global integrated civilization. Thank you. You are strictly on time. And finally, Professor Krichevsky is here. He's here. I believe that our soup will not get cold and we'll finish this session. Transition towards green technological mode through the management of spectrum of technologies.
Thank you, Yuri Vladimirovich. Dear colleagues, dear friends, talking about the technological session at the Centennial Plan, about the transition to a healthening of the global ecological environment, we can't not talk about the technologies and the most important. If we don't learn how to manage technologies, how to ecologize all the technical activities, nothing is going to happen to the company. Talking about the certain features of the moment, there is a conference and whatsoever. The transition from brown economy to green economy. In Russia, a reform is this progress of the state policy in this respect. Year 2013, the year of ecology in this country, Safety Council talked about it, and today, the All-Russia Congress on the protection of the environment is finalizing today. What is said that we are not solving these problems properly, while the understanding of the problem is in place. I will present to you the results of the interdisciplinary research. We have developed the new methodological approach to analysis and assessment of techniques and technologies for the in my opinion, the new view on the technological strata, technological pattern. In my opinion, technological strata can be understood as a domineering mode of interaction between the society and environment. It is the cluster of technologies. It is ecological, technological strata status in new paradigm of the green development. Rio Plus 20, in the newest history of science, we are talking about the beginning of the transition to the green technologies, the transition to green technological, green energetics, green transportation, the green for the green future. There is an initiative for green economy.
Трактуя и в концепции зеленой экономики, отмечаю, что мы сейчас живем в коричневой экономике.
We are now living in the brown economy. Of course, I must apologize for the similarity to the substrate. So we are in.
В случае коричневым определяется преобладающим.
The substrate is ecologically dirty. For transition from the old brown and dirty to new clean green, we have to exercise the massive transfer to green technologies. The new methodological approach is based on three things. New eco approach to ecological. Nano bio, it is absolutely senseless in terms of, in the context of healthening of the environment. New classification of techniques and technologies for classes, brown and green economies, green and black and white can be added to these two. The third point is the model of assessment model in the coordinates of the consuming.
Еще следующий.
Consumption
вот рисунок,
and,
да? На нем формате, если здесь мы смотрим на загрязнение,
on this page we see on this matrix we see the polluting, consuming, renewable resources. We have to identify four areas: black and inappropriate area. Next is brown, where we are now. The green area, which we are getting closer and closer, moving or pushing the green. Which is modeling the resources and minimizing the refuse, and white is our final objective.
Здесь подробности далее. Границы между видами вот этих технологий и так далее, они
boundaries between these technologies, between these modes. Can change with time. Criteria of ecological criteria of the boundaries between the classes of technologies with implementation, with the progressing, increasing implementation of green technologies can change. But we have to analyze the spectral analysis of the existing technologies ensures the identification of green technologies.
We have to refuse the decline black
technologies, black and to minimize brown technologies, stimulate green, and to strive for white. This is the logic underlying logic of the project. I will skip the details to save some time for the dinner. Analysis of the rocket industries and technologies. We are talking about China and Russia, in carriers of the rocket carriers, the fuels used there. Гептил is over-toxic technologies, they're black technologies, they should be banned. Brown technologies are kerosene and oxygen. It's a mess, technologies are now the best of the affordable. Of course, they're still dirty. Green is hydrogen and water energetics, and white is a principal new rocket-free electromagnetic technology. Cool, whatever, like from the.
Следующий, пожалуйста.
Next slide, please.
Листайте. Коллега, нажмите на кнопку.
Push the button, please, will you?
It's
it's time.
The
green process is embracing everything, but the analysis of the assessment of the innovative technology, it is the most important step. We are not analyzing the spectrum of technologies, we are not worshipping this mode, but they are not they don't correspond with the ecological environment. How we shall evolve
some of
the technologies by LEM. We have talked about the compromise, feasible technologies, green technologies with minimum pollution and minimum consumption of energy consumption. Why we should analyze and norm in order to manage the inherited technologies, the best of the existing technologies and the green technologies. Since 2010, 2,000, more than 2,000 patents for green ecologies, green technologies were registered in the world, the majority in the United States, then in the BRICS countries. And next slide, please. In European countries, for example, it's in legally norm the best technologies. We are behind it for at least 20 years, and our business is breaking this process. Though our leaders, our authorities are trying to implement the market for the innovative technologies will reach the 4 trillion rubles or grow 10 times in 20 years. So I will skip all this, right. We can come to the conclusion that prevailing type of technologies are black and brown. What can be done?
So
the Russian proverb says that the black dog cannot be washed to become white. We must manage the transition from one economic mode to another, banning black technologies, there should be black lists of banned technologies. So this label is none of being, and such we have to absolutely strictly distinguish between black, brown, green technologies. There's the black technologies, they are being banned by law, and we restrict brown technologies, providing a time limit for them, motivate and stimulate the implementation of green, and develop white technologies.
Необходимые индикаторы следующие.
Necessary indicators and the income.
Предстоит разработать критерии, стандарты,
we have to develop the criteria, standards, indicated proportions, and to implement them into all the industries.
То есть необходимо организовать управление процессом зеленого развития
the process of green technologies through managing existing technologies. The objective is to transition to all green new ecologic mode. How from green dreams we can switch to green policy, green law, standards, and to green economy and green society, green future. Next slide. Thank you very much for your attention. Thanks for everybody for all the people presented. We listened to many different approaches. The problem is calls for more and more work to be done. I want to pay attention to this is an absolutely unique book which contains the forecast for the period up to 2050 in the world and in Russia. And it, for the first time, it is given in terms of civilization cycles and the world and Eurasian technologies. I wish you good lunch. We've worked a lot, successful work. Thank you all for active participation and bon appétit.
Спасибо. Ничего.